Very good morning, children. In a previous class of that lesson, biogeochemical cycles, you learned about the water cycle. So how that water from oceans, it is going to be reaching the atmosphere. From atmosphere again, it forms the, it changes to clouds. Then how again it is reaching the earth. So that we learnt in the cycle called biogeochemical, that water cycle, and what is the how much water is present and how much water is useful as fresh water, and how the water is getting transferred. Then how the water cycle is disturbed, all that we have discussed. So today we are going to discuss about the another important cycle, that is the nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen cycle. You know that air is a mixture of gases, and different components are present in the air, like oxygen is there, then nitrogen is there, carbon dioxide is there, sulfur dioxide is there. So many gases are there in the atmosphere. So the atmosphere contains 78% of nitrogen. 78% of nitrogen is present. Now what is the use of this nitrogen? Means that nitrogen, whichever is present in the atmosphere, it has to reach the living system. Okay, so in the living system, in what way this nitrogen is helping, means it helps in the growth, development, and body repair, and synthesis of nucleic acids. So all these are going to happen, that is because of nitrogen. Is it clear to you? So now in this topic, what we are learning, how that atmospheric nitrogen is going to be transferred from abiotic system to biotic system, means from atmosphere, how it is entering into the plants, then animals, and again how it will be back to the environment, that we are going to discuss now in this class. Coming to the next point here, nitrogen, it is present abundantly in atmosphere, that is 78%, that nitrogen is not taken up or not used up by the organisms. Is it clear to children? So because it is in the elemental form, inert form, so that nitrogen whichever is there, it has to be converted to the some other forms of nitrogen, means salts of nitrogen it has to form. Then only from that from the atmosphere, the nitrogen is going to be entering into the living system. Then from that living system, it is going to be changed. So that nitrogen is directly taken up by the plants. So you know that herbivorous animals, and indirectly other animals like carnivorous animals and human beings, indirectly we are going to depend on the atmospheric nitrogen. So that all how it is happening, that we are learning in the lesson nitrogen cycle. So this atmospheric nitrogen is going to be converted to the salts of nitrogen by through biochemical process. Biochemical process by which means some kind of microorganisms. You know that that bacteria, whichever is present, bacteria. So this bacteria is present in the free living in the atmosphere as free living bacteria. Apart from that, symbiotically the bacteria is living in the root nodules of bean family plants. So they are going to help in convert that nitrogen into the salts of nitrogen. Or you know that physiochemical process. So where it is happening? So that atmospheric nitrogen, so you know that before rain starts, how it will be, we will be observing thunders and lightning will be observing. So in that process also, the nitrogen present in the atmosphere will be converted to the nitrogen compounds. So in lightning, in a lightning, that nitrogen will be converted. So whatever that nitrogen, whichever is converted to the salts of nitrogen, so it reaches the earth, then it will be present in the soil. So from the soil, the plants are going to make use of it, and the plants are making use of it in their metabolic activities like photosynthesis. You know that what is the importance of nitrogen means? Nitrogen helps in formation of chlorophyll. So that chlorophyll is because of nitrogen only, and new flowers, new leaves or new plant parts are going to be developed, that is because of nitrogen. Then protein formation also, in the process of photosynthesis the food is also prepared, is it not children? So that food, whichever is prepared, it is going to be used by the plants, and some will be stored in different parts of the plants, and that we are going to make use of it. Is it clear to you? So in that way, from plants, then it will be, nitrogen will be entering into the animals, which are said to be herbivorous, and if herbivores are going to become food for other organisms, that carnivores are going to make use of it, like that in a cyclic manner that nitrogen is going to. As you know that if that nitrogen abundantly, even if it is present in the atmosphere, that nitrogen cannot be used up by the plants directly. Is it clear to you? So even if that 78% of nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, it cannot be used up. Then how it is made available to the different organisms means, so there are different steps or different stages are present where that nitrogen is going to be converted into different forms, and how it is going to be entering into the living organisms. Is it clear to you? So there are different stages or several stages in the nitrogen cycle. So what are the different stages present in the nitrogen cycle? First one is a nitrogen fixation. Nitrogen fixation. Is it clear to you? So the first step in the nitrogen cycle is a nitrogen fixation. Then second one is a nitrification. Nitrification. Then third one, assimilation. Third one is assimilation. Then fourth one is ammonification. Ammonification. And fifth one is said to be denitrification. Denitrification. So through all these stages, the atmospheric nitrogen from the abiotic component or abiotic system, it enters, and finally after this denitrification, again it will be back to the atmosphere. So now what are the different stages present in nitrogen cycle? One is said to be nitrogen fixation, nitrification, assimilation, ammonification and denitrification. So now let us learn what is the meaning of nitrogen fixation and how it is happening, and what do you mean by nitrification, assimilation, ammonification and denitrification. Is it clear to children? So as you learned just now that nitrogen is very much important for the growth, development, body repair work, or synthesis of nucleic acids, that is preparation of nucleic acids. All this is going to happen in the organisms, that is because of nitrogen only. So now this nitrogen fixation, how it is going to happen, that we will learn. So now atmospheric nitrogen is said to be present in the inert form or non-reactive form. Non-reactive form. Is it clear to children? So that nitrogen, whichever is present in the atmosphere, is said to be non-reactive or in the inert form. Inert form means what? It is not going to be taking part in the reactions. Is it clear to you? So because of that, what will happen? This nitrogen is not going to be directly used up by the plants or any other organism. So how the plants are going to make use of that nitrogen means mostly by the biological process. Biological process. So, in what way this biological process is going to happen, or which help in fixing the atmospheric nitrogen means, so bacteria. So, some kind of bacteria, like free living bacteria, present in the atmosphere. So, in the air, free living bacteria is present, like Nitrosomonas. Example, Nitrosomonas and Azotobacter and Nitrosomonas are the free living bacteria. Apart from that, another kind of organisms are also there. They are said to be blue green algae. So they are all going to make use of this nitrogen. Is it clear to you? So through this biological process, the atmospheric nitrogen is going to be entering, or this bacteria like Nitrosomonas or Azotobacter and blue green algae, they are going to convert that nitrogen of atmosphere into the compounds of nitrogen. Is it clear to you? Then that nitrogen is present in their body, and that nitrogen is made useful for the those bacteria and blue green algae also. They are also making use of nitrogen, because all living organisms are in need of nitrogen. So these are also making use of that nitrogen. And you know that bacteria or algae, they are said to be growing at faster rate and dying also at faster rate. So after they die, what will happen means, the nitrogen compounds whichever are present in their body will be present in the soil, and from the soil the nitrogen is going to be used up by the plants or the crops which the farmers are going to grow. Then from the soil the nitrogen is entering into the plants, and the plants are going to make use of nitrogen. So here another example also we have to take. What is that means? Some kind of bacteria are present in the some plants. So what are those plants? You have studied in the previous class also. What are those plants means, like legume plants or bean family plants. Okay, so legume plants or bean family plants, if we observe the root system of those plants, like groundnut, Bengal gram or horse gram, or pea plants, or any beans plants, if we observe any bean family, if we observe, so this is the taproot system, and lateral roots we can observe here. So on the roots we can see large number of root nodules. So nodule or forms we can see. Is it clear to children? So they are called as root nodules. So if we dissect this nodule, and if we observe it under the microscope, you can see large number of bacteria, which we call them as rhizobia plural. Is it clear to you? So in the root nodules of bean family plants, so what are they? They are said to be root nodules. Okay, so in the root nodules of legume plants or bean family plants, example, groundnut or beans or Bengal gram, horse gram, etc. So in all these plants, the roots contain nodules, which we call them as root nodules. In that, a bacteria is living, large number of bacteria are present, which we call them as rhizobium. Okay, singular, rhizobia plural. So this rhizobia bacteria is going to convert the atmospheric nitrogen into salts of nitrogen. Okay, so in that way here the bacteria is getting shelter from the plant. Is it clear to you? And the bacteria is giving nitrogen to the plant, and the plant is giving shelter to the bacteria. Is it clear to you? So the inside the root nodules of bean family plants, this bacteria is living. So now the bacteria is giving nitrogen to the plant, and that plant is giving shelter to the bacteria. So here both organisms are getting benefit from each other. Mutual benefit is there. So what do we call that type of relationship? Means that one we call it as a symbiotic relation. Symbiotic relationship. So what does it mean? Symbiotic relationship means that is an example of a nutrition, one kind of nutrition, mixotrophic nutrition. Is it clear to children? So symbiotic relationship means what here? Both the organisms, so two different organisms are there. One is bacteria and other one is said to be plant. So both are getting benefit from each other. Is it clear to you? So that one we call it as a symbiotic relationship. Is it clear to you? So symbiosis. So in that way, the plants are making use of nitrogen, which is fixed in the plants of bean family plants. Whereas in biological process, the free living bacteria, Azotobacter or Nostoca or Anabina, what do they do? Anabina and Nostoca are said to be blue green algae. Okay, Azotobacter is a free living, fixing atmospheric nitrogen into the salts of nitrogen in the plants. So that will be used up by the plants. So what do we call that process? Means that process is called as nitrogen fixation. Look at this the flow chart. What it is going to make you to understand means nitrogen fixation, first step of a nitrogen cycle. So the atmospheric nitrogen, whichever is present, it is going to be fixed, that is by nitrogen fixing bacteria. So that nitrogen fixing bacteria, we learnt symbiotic bacteria, then free living bacteria. So they are going to fix that atmospheric nitrogen, and as they are dying at faster rate, and they grow also faster, that bacteria. Okay, and after the death of these organisms, it will be present in the soil. So now here in the soil, that nitrogen, whatever it is there, it is made available to the plants. So plants are going to make use of it. Then after the death of then from the plants, consumers here. Consumers means what are they? Directly. So herbivores are going to make use of the nitrogen whichever is fixed in the plants. Indirectly, that carnivorous animals, because they eat the flesh of other animals, like herbivores. Carnivores are going to eat the herbivores. Herbivores are directly depending on the plants. So the nitrogen whichever is fixed in the plants, it is going to be entering into the consumers. So what is going to happen? Plants and animals, after the death, detritivores, what is happening? Again, it will be back to the soil. And you learned that some of the nitrogen is going to be fixed or is converted to the salts of nitrogen because of lightning, like a physiochemical process. Like you learned or not, children? Just now I said during the lightning. So at that time also, that atmospheric nitrogen is converted and it forms as some sediments, like clays, rocks or sediments. It is forming and it is reaching the earth, then it is reaching the soil. So from the soil, again the plants are going to make use of that nitrogen. Then you know that nitrogen whichever is present in the soil, when it is reaching the biotic system, whether they are plants or consumers or decomposers, whatever it may be, in what way that nitrogen is essential means the nitrogen is helping for growth, development, means the organism has to survive, and the activities, metabolic activities has to be carried out, and all the parts have to be developed, or the repair work has to be carried out, means that is because of nitrogen. So in that way, the nitrogen fixation is going to happen. So please note down it. Students, till now you learned about the nitrogen fixation. So we learn about the second stage, that is nitrification. What is the meaning of nitrification? Means the nitrogen whichever is fixed in the plants in the form of compounds of nitrogen. Okay, so that nitrogen is made available to the plants or animals or other microorganisms. So that process of conversion, that one we call it as here nitrification. So here nitrification especially here what is happening means that nitrates whichever are formed are going to be converted to nitrates are converted to ammonia. So this ammonia whichever is formed used by the microorganisms. So microorganisms are going to be using of it. So what bacteria or what microorganism means nitrifying bacteria. Is going to convert this nitrates to ammonia, like salts of nitrogen, nitrites and nitrates. So this nitrifying bacteria is going to make use of that nitrogen and synthesize the compounds, and those compounds are used up by them. Okay, so nitrates are produced mainly by nitrosomonas and nitrates by nitrobacter. Nitrites are formed because of nitrosomonas and nitrates are formed by nitrobacter. So these two are bacteria. So nitrosomonas is making that salts of nitrogen, converting that nitrogen to ammonia, and nitrites also. So these nitrites are again converted to nitrates by nitrobacter. So these two are going to make use of them, and some amount of nitrogen which is present in the form of salts of nitrogen like nitrites or nitrates are used up by the plants. Okay, so that process we call it as nitrification, and they are going to make use of it, and which help in the formation of nucleic acids. Ammonia is going to be used up by the plants or the microorganisms or even other living organisms for the production of nucleic acids and proteins. So in that way, that nitrogen whichever is fixed is going to be made available to the different organisms. So that nitrobacter and nitrosomonas bacteria are going to convert that to nitrogen to ammonia and other compounds of nitrogen. So they are going to make use of it, like for synthesis of nucleic acids or proteins or other activities happen to in their body. So after the death of these organisms, so the soil will have that nitrogen compounds, and from the soil the plants are going to make use of it. Then the plants are also making use of that nitrogen, and which helps in the formation of nucleic acids and proteins, etc. So now nitrification is summarized. So the summary of nitrogen nitrification is learned through a flowchart. So this flowchart is going to make you to understand the process of nitrification. So nitrates whichever are formed, they are acted by denitrifying bacteria and convert it into ammonia. It is also a product or compound like nitrogen only. So that ammonia, the organisms are going to make use for their survival, and after they die, so they are again acted by nitrosomonas bacteria, and this ammonia is converted to nitrite. So this nitrites are acted by nitrobacter, another bacteria, and they will be converted to nitrate. So then this nitrate is in the form of salts of nitrogen is made available to the plants, and these plants are using nitrates as well as ammonium ions, and that will help for the synthesis of nucleic acids and growth, development, etc. Even proteins. Is it clear to you? So, in today's class, we learned about the nitrogen fixation and nitrification. So, tomorrow we'll continue the class.